Hello, my name is Trayvon Lee, and today I will assist you in using the updated Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2019. You would need to be in the production class which uses it. That would be any except filmmaking 1 and audio and radio production. If the program is not taught in class, you would need to pass the competency test to use it in our editing rooms. To begin, you will need to log into EditShare and mount the proper drives. Next, head down to Adobe Premiere Pro application on the desktop. This will take a minute to load all the hardware processors. Once everything is loaded, you'll be asked to sign in. In order to do so, simply type in your student account email and then hit sign in. You will be asked to use either personal or enterprise ID, so click the latter. Now you'll be transported to WP Connect login screen. So just sign in as you usually do. Now you are signed in to Adobe Creative Cloud. Now you want to get started and create your project. So click New Project on the left-hand side of the window. You'll be asked to give it a name. Give it one you can easily remember and recognize to associate with that project. Next, it's time to set the location. This is directly below the name. Next to the location is the button Browse, which makes finding a specific folder much easier. We're gonna click that to find our destination. Locate your classes, SMB, or Adobe Drive, and your folder. Click Choose when you have it set. You're not quite done yet, so don't move ahead. Under Location, there is a tab for Scratch Disk. You want to make sure everything is set to same as project, so your files aren't all over the place. Now you can hit OK in the bottom right. The Adobe Premiere program is now ready to edit, but you have no videos or audio clips. You can easily gather them. In the bottom left corner lies a small window. From there, you want to click on Media Browser. Locate the place you saved your clips. You probably have a lot of clips, so you don't want to import them one by one. Click the first and hold Shift. Now click the last clip. Now that they're all selected, hold Control and click on any clip. Second on that list, there is Import to import your clips into Premiere. Once they've all finished exporting, now you can find them in Project, your project name, tab. You can preview these clips before adding them to your timeline. Just double-click the clip you would like to see. It will appear in the preview window right above it. You were likely on camera caught saying rolling, speeding, or action, so we need to cut that out. We do so with markers. Select the point of the clip you are satisfied with beginning with, and set your end marker. This tells Premiere that you wanted to start here, and everything before it isn't necessary. You can either click the bracket, or you can use a shortcut I on your keyboard. Next, you want to mark your ending point so that you don't get yourself saying cut. Once again, locate the point you are satisfied with and select this with the close bracket or hit O this time. You'll still have the full clip so you can edit it later if you feel you messed up and you need a little more room. You are now ready to drag the clip onto your timeline. A handy note, if you would like just a video, click and drag the film roll icon below your preview video. You can do the same for just audio by clicking and dragging the waveform icon right next to that. You can do the same for all your clips in your project. Once your clip is in your timeline, you can now edit it further. There are several tools to help edit and locate it between your project space and the timeline. There's Select to grab and select your clips. There's Track Select Forward to move a clip and every clip behind it as well. There's Ripple, which allows you to adjust the length of a clip without editing the other clips. You can also move everything else before or after to select a point, as well to keep the flow set, but you need to have enough space to do so. Next is the Razor tool. This allows you to cut a clip up. This is mainly used to add effects to a certain part of a clip. Now we move on to the slip tool. This allows you to adjust the length of a clip while also overriding the clip before or after. Next is the pin tool. That's mainly for graphics and keyframes. Following that is the hand tool, which helps you move around the timeline much easier. Finally is text, and that allows you to click on a video and add a title. Another thing you may want to use in your editing is transitions. This covers up cuts and gets creative with your clips. To add one, head over to your project space window. Using the arrows, you can navigate over to effects. This brings up a huge list of possible effects and transitions, but I want a simple cross dissolve. For that, I need to go to video transitions and open that folder. Dissolve, and now I can find it. To apply it to the clips, simply drag it over to where the clips meet, and it's set. When your project is fully completed and you are satisfied, you are now done and can export it. Make sure your timeline's already set. Now go back up to File, head to Export, and Media. Once the export settings window is up, make sure your format is set to H.264, which will export your project to an MP4. Following that, click the output name and this prompting window asks you to title it, the tags to use for it, and where you want to save it. Once it's all good, click Save. Now you should be ready to export, so click Export in the bottom right corner to do so. Exporting will take some time depending on how much you edit in it, the effects, and more. Now you are a pro at Adobe Premiere. Those are the basics to use it of Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2019. Thanks for watching. Be sure to ask TSW if you have any other questions pertaining to Adobe Premiere or any other programs. We are happy to help.